Hey viewers, today I'll be sharing with you 7 tips on how to choose a preschool, a playschool, a kindergarten or a nursery. So now, this is very, very important for the parents who are putting their kids for the first time in school, and we parents become very choosy and very selective about that and how could we get the best school for our little ones. So now, today I'll be sharing some of the tips that how could you choose the best one for the little ones. Before going to that video, before sharing the first point with you, I would like to request you, if you like my videos, please don't forget to like, share, subscribe and hit the bell icon so once I post my videos next time, it reaches you fast. So point number one is budget. Budget is very important, as we all know, it's a matter of affordability. So list out the schools in your locality or in your area which fits in your budget. And number two is know your child. So now, who could better do that other than parents? Only parents know their child the best. Some kids have illness like asthma, allergy, someone is having accent problems, someone is little less confident, some kids are very much into activity, they love to do activity, some are very hyperactive kids. Now the parent needs to understand what are the specialties of your child. So that would help you in the selection process of the school. Point number three is understanding the framework. So Montessori method is something that many of the preschools use that in their daily learning process. So but then other than Montessori, there are other processes like Highscope approach, or there is Waldorf approach or Amelia approach. So you need to choose, you need to know about that, and you need to choose which school follows which one and exactly which one suits for your child. Number four point is emotional support. Now what is emotional support? When the kid is going out from your home and meeting his teacher or his friends in the classroom for the first time, so it's kind of a whole new world for him or her. So in that case, the teacher should be very much supportive, and supporting in a point is kind of, the teacher should be very much interactive with the child. She should talk, so she should make a very good bonding with the child, and that is how the student will feel like this place is okay, I can stay, this place is fine, I have someone with whom I can share my problems or I can share my happiness. And that's how your child will be more emotionally attached with the teacher, or she will, or he or she will make a very good bonding. So only instructing, sit here, stand up, do your work won't help. Needs to interact. A teacher needs to interact and be close to your child. And number five, time and schedule. Time and schedule is very important because nowadays both these parents are working. You need to choose a school that fits in your time schedule and that won't hamper you. If you are happy, then obviously your child will be happy. So try to choose a school that fits in your time and schedule. Point number six is location. Location is very important because as the child is going for the first time to the school should not be far, it should be nearby, so that your child doesn't lose his energy or her energy while traveling on the roads. So try to choose a school very close to your location where you stay. Point number seven is cleanliness and safety. Now coming to the point, cleanliness. Cleanliness is very important because for the first time your kid is going out, and as soon as he is going out, he will be getting attacked with many kind of viruses and diseases. If the school is clean, the bathrooms are clean, the classrooms are clean, and they follow the proper cleaning system, your child will be much, much better. Now the point of safety. Safety is very important because as we know, the world is becoming very, very unsafe today, and the school needs to follow certain rules that they are not allowing any unknown person during the school hours in the school premises. And also during the pickup and drop off, this is very important. School should not leave your child to any unknown person. So these are the points that you should always discuss with the school authority. And also the school infrastructure matters. Like suppose the school is having a indoor and outdoor playground, so until it's indoor it's safe, but once it's outdoor, how much safety they are giving when the kids are outside, that's important. The park, if it's a park, then how far is the park? The park should be next to the school. If it's not next to the school, if there is a point of going little far, then there is obviously some risk. So you need to keep this point in mind. Next, number eight point is, yes, number eight point. And that's a bonus point for you because you are still logged in my channel. And the bonus point is, may I come in? So what is may I come in? The school authority should allow you to meet with your child whenever you feel like meeting them in the school time. And at the same time, the school authority should allow you to talk with the teacher or the principal. So there should be no hide and seek about this matter. I hope my today's video is going to help you. If you like my videos, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And don't forget to hit the bell icon. If you hit the bell icon, you will get my videos very fast next time. Till then, keep waiting for my next videos. This is Sharmi signing off for now. Bye. Take care.